And now, currently, we don't have a good school system. Your hospital, you have to buy your medicine to bring to the hospital. There is no bed in the hospital, and the condition is very, very bad. And the fishing industry, people are in the coastal, so we do fishing a lot. And the oil is polluting the fish, and also cause the infertility. We have a lot of infertility in our tribe, and have that again. And then they pinch the politician. When the politician, they are the one. And oil and petroleum department answer to Exxon and Shell Oil. They don't answer to Nigerian government. And then they train their leaders from one family to the other, so that no matter what the good side are talking.
The great eco warrior, Allie Tharp of Texas Action Coalition for the Environment.
Nobody knew about the Pegasus pipeline before it ruptured on March 29, 2013. Not even the people who had spent years trying to educate the public about tar sands, about the Keystone XL pipeline in progress. Not even the most dedicated activists knew about the Pegasus pipeline, which was carrying tar sands bitumen from Canada before it erupted on March 29, 2013. And we should ask ourselves why. It's not because people don't care, it's because Exxon profits upon misinformation and discretion of information. Exxon benefited from buying a pipeline that was 60 years old, keeping it out of the public eye, and pumping tar sands bitumen through it for years. And so what happened is another instance of misinformation, of lying to the public, and of people being the ones who received all of the damage, all of the harm from that happening. When it spilled, first...
Not paying your taxes, there's a lot of things you can get arrested for. We've heard a little bit about what Exxon has done. We've heard they took part in the Iraq War, that they were part of the reason for the Iraq War. The Iraq War killed millions of people. That's the epidemiological evidence is that the number of deaths attributable to the Iraq War is in the millions. You don't ever hear that. You hear about, what is it, 6,000-7,000 American deaths. You don't hear how many Iraqi soldiers were killed, and you sure don't hear about the civilian death toll. But it did, in the millions. You heard about in deaths. Many years ago, when Tony Blair was the Prime Minister of Great Britain, there's a position in Britain called the Royal Astronomer. That's the chief scientist in Britain. And the fellow who at that time was the Royal Astronomer got in a lot of trouble because he pointed out that even then, global warming had clearly killed more people than terrorism ever did. How has global warming killed people? It's killed people mainly through water, either through drought or through floods. In Bangladesh, every year they have...
Let's save the status quo. If a great big corporation